Hello, everyone, and welcome to another presentation for Valencia Design Education Forum. Today we have with us Isabel Vachmuth, and Isabel is going to tell us a bit about her presentation. So, Isabel, what is the subject of your presentation for the forum?
Thank you so much, Lefteris, and I am so happy to join you now for this extraordinary forum about, you know, specifically education, but as well creativity, and creativity in design. And the project of World Health Organization is I am leading, it's exactly about, you know, collective creativity. And the idea, it is to bring together, you know, scientists and as well artists together. Not just that, but, you know, as a scientist, I will mention, for example, policymakers, researchers, people from civil society are, you know, in charge to implement, for example, the policies, you know, have been decided by the policymaker. How the idea it was to bring the artistic component, you know. Why? Because we need to communicate in a more efficient way, and specifically to be sure people can really understand, you know, on different perspectives, different angles, you know, the societal challenge or health issue we face. And this innovative, you know, I will say incubator called Art Impact for Health, it is how we can use art expression, you know, and the talent of artists to communicate about any type of challenge or issue, you know, artistically, additionally to just data, you know, evidence are more quantitative, and art expression is more qualitative. And with art, you can really contextualize as well, you know, very well the topic you will address, and you will be able to translate it in with one universal language, you know, all the people can understand it, you know. That it is the beauty of art, because art is really a universal language, you know, and we have discovered that have no borders. And how we are doing that? In fact, the idea it is to work at country level, because countries are so important, you know, and specifically to address the most vulnerable, you know, population. For example, the children, you know, in some countries, in some low middle income countries, you know, are in remote areas. They have not easy access to healthcare. And with some key partners over the world, for example, SmileTrain, we are partner with SmileTrain to address the children suffer of the cleft, you know, issue on their face, and it's difficult for them, you know, to have access to essential, you know, chirurgical care, for example, you know. Donc, the idea it is to support not in this case the children, but as well the families, you know, the community, you know, and to be sure these children will be able to have hope and to see themselves, you know, with good image as well, like the other children. And for that, we have developed a methodology, and we have done a very amazing workshop in Peru recently. It was in the beginning of 2020, before the lockdowns after the crisis. And it was beautiful because it was to regroup different children, you know, in Lima, in one hospital. It is an hospital able to take care, to identify these children and to take care about them with the support of this international, you know, organization called SmileTrain. And what we have done, it is to involve, of course, the head of this clinic, and as well to involve 20 local artists. Wow. In Lima, And all these local artists, for some of them, they are like me, scientists and artists, because me, I am a biologist, but as well, I am an artist, I am a painter. So it's how you associate, you know, your scientist part and your artistic part together. Of course, to bring some humanity, you know, and to create more authentic relationship, fruitful relationship with all the people around of you. And it was very powerful because these 20 artists have been able to co-create beautiful masks. This mask was, you know, to show, including with the cleft, you know, on your face, the way you see you with the beauty, we cannot see cleft after that. You know what I mean? Like you can reappropriate yourself, self-esteem, your identity, your image. And all these children have been able to participate, you know, in this co-creation process and to do, you know, the painting of their own mask, you know, and how they see themselves, you know. And it was beautiful because they see themselves very colorful, full of hope and joy. Donc, they have been able to see, but they are not alone, you know, you have other children, you know, in the country of this health issue, you know, and they are like a community, you know. And as well for the parents, it's very important because like that, they are not isolated and they can communicate with each other. And the request of the parents, it was how we can continue to do that at home. Donc, the idea with this partner, it was as well to create like a booklet, you know, like a kit to say, okay, here it is the methodology you can use and you can do it by yourself and at home you can continue to be creative, to create with your children, you know, and to have nice time, you know, together, including with the lockdown, because it was an issue as well for them, you know, psychologically. After that, the idea is to showcase. We have done this process as well, not just in Peru, but in with Morocco. And for example, with Morocco, we have worked with the hospital from Mohammed VI, you know, in Marrakech. And it's amazing because the health professional and specifically the head of this hospital have been able to institutionalize in the hospital a full program of art and healing, if you want. And to give, you know, art session, art creation, art expression, you know, for women, you know, with cancer, for the services to the people are in palliative care, you know, the full range, you know, of the different health services, you know, in this hospital, have been able to really embrace, in fact, one component about art. And I think that is part of education, is part of education curriculum, you know what I mean? How we can touch different people where they are, you know, and in each time of their life, you know, and creativity need to be on lifelong, you know, learning and discovery. The results are amazing, and I hope many hospitals in the world, but not just hospitals, but schools, for example, or country can decide to institutionalize as well this use of creativity through art, you know, to create the best potential of any people in the world, you know, including if you are, you know, with disabilities, you know, with specific sickness, but, you know, you have such a potential and as well to recover your health.
Yes, absolutely. Fantastic.
That it is our experience. And after, the idea it is to showcase all we are doing at country level, at international level, because like that, the international audience, and specifically our big partner like UNESCO, United Nations, and so on, can see the impact of what we are doing. And we have recently been able to present beautiful art exhibit in United Nations Geneva about, you know, the sustainable development goals, you know, and how, for example, 33 artists have been able to translate together, you know, the view of these sustainable development goals, you know. Donc, that it is how we can communicate collectively at country level, regional level, and international level to have more big impact.
Very exciting. That's very exciting. Fantastic. So we're looking very much forward to your conversation and, of course, to the panel afterwards, which is going to be with all the participants. Are there any questions that you'd like to know about the forum or anything that is not clear so far? Do you have any questions?
Yeah, my question it is how is perceived, you know, what you are doing specifically in education now to have an impact of the mindset of people, you know, and to be sure, you know, in education, you know, curricula, we have this collective creativity, you know, is value, is institutionalized, including in the university, in the school. What it is your advancement, you know, through the forum and with all the people, you know, are connected in your forum to do that, to move together forward?
Yeah, I mean, the whole point is to go into action. You know, there's no point in looking more at the problem. We can't be just looking at the problem. You know, there's a term for that in research. It's called reflexive research or practice-based research. But very little of that is taking place. So the forum is dedicated to practitioners like yourself that want to do, want to apply, they want to go to the stage of doing it, not about thinking about doing it, because a lot of the conversation now is around thinking about doing. And thinking about doing doesn't really provide any solutions. It just provides more thinking, and so that's the whole point of Valencia Design Education Forum this year, and of course, hopefully every year, to foster collaborations and conversations, but that can be immediately applied. So hopefully, all the speakers will talk about something that everybody can take and apply the same day in what they're doing. But the most important thing is to apply. And then see how that application has given solutions.
Yes. Yes, because after you can share, you know, your experience, how it was, and as well, the fact you can share this experience, you can inspire, of course, each other, you know, and identify what it is the most inspirational, you know, and again, to apply in different contexts.
Absolutely.
Because, the beauty it is to look as well what can be applied at universal level, you know, what are common between individuals and not different, you know, what are common in the sense of humanity, you know?
Indeed.
And human in general, human being have the same, you know, needs. Yes. In terms of needs, you want some hope, you want to develop yourself. You want to interconnect in very beautiful way with the other, you know, you want to create authentic relationship. Donc, it is really about that and how we communicate on our essential needs, you know, not just the food. The access to food is so important, but that is to reflect in a holistic way. You know what I mean? We cannot forget, you know, more big purpose of needs, you know, in life, you know, what it is, for example, our relationship or communion with our environment, with the nature around of us, you know, because that we are interdependent, you know, to each other. And I think that needs to be as well part of the new narrative not based on fear, but based, you know, on hope, on joy, you know, and how we can recreate, you know, this collective beauty, in fact, with creativity.
Very good. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Isabel. We look forward to connecting with you in the forum. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.